Hello, this is Charles.
Hey, Charles, it's John. How are you?
Hey, John, doing well. How are you doing?
Good, good. How's the family doing?
Oh, they're doing great. Just got back from vacation for a couple days and just kind of settling back in now.
Nice. Where'd you guys go?
We actually went to Puerto Vallarta, Mexico. It was beautiful out there.
Wow, I love that place. I used to go there all the time as a kid, and it was just one of my favorite memories because I remember going out on the boat and doing some deep sea fishing, and I caught a mahi-mahi. It was 50 pounds, so it was a
Awesome.
great time.
Wow.
Yeah, so I'm glad you had a great time with the family. So, well, hey, did I catch you at a good time at all, or is this a bad?
Yeah, I got a couple minutes.
Yeah, good. Well, hey, I wanted to round up with you. I'm just really, first off, just I've enjoyed getting to know you. And, just I guess more than anything, what I've really enjoyed is, one of the things we always try to focus on is, deepening relationships with people that we really respect, that, are high integrity people and, high connectors in the community and just high givers. And I've just really, it's been fun. Because it's a rarity just getting to know you and the way that you operate. So just want to let you know that, it's been great. So thank you. And one of the things that we, I'm really trying to do more of is to deepen these kinds of relationships that I have to where there's this real mutual, almost kind of partnership-oriented relationship where we can really help each other expand, grow the respective business that we're trying to do. So I'm sure that there's things that you're trying to accomplish right now within your business in terms of people you're trying to get connected with, I'm assuming. Would that sound correct?
Yeah, absolutely.
What specifically would you say are the types of people that you're wanting to get in front of, or the targeted people that you're trying to meet? Is there any specific people that are best suited for you at all?
I am an investor, so there are times where I could really use a reliable commercial real estate broker that's local, understands the area, someone that just has, high integrity, is able to do a good job, they're responsive. Because, in these hot markets, sometimes you're just kind of a number. And I just want to have that level of service where we can really just establish a good relationship.
That's great. Yeah, we definitely, I have a handful of people that I really respect and trust. There's not a lot of them, but there's a few that I really have a deep amount of respect and trust with that I would be absolutely happy to make those introductions for you just to help you accomplish what it is that you're trying to do. And, just one of the things that we're trying to do is to keep expanding these relationships. There's kind of two types. There's direct, relationships that we're looking for, people that do, multifamily, self-storage, industrial. We're really trying to get in front of more, real estate attorneys that are a great fit for us, as well as specific types of commercial bankers, commercial brokers. Those are good, really good referral relationships. And again, it's all under the guise of what we consider people that are real high integrity people, good connectors and just great people that are focused on giving. They just have that attitude. And so I wanted to just see, do you think it would make sense for you and I to have that kind of ongoing relationship going forward?
Yeah, absolutely. Would love that.
Yeah, that's great. So what would it look like for you? I mean, what do you see that looking like? Is that something that we end up just, talking every month, or what would be at appropriate frequency so I'm not, overwhelming you, but making sure that there's an appropriate cadence to what you're trying to do.
Yeah, I think every 6 weeks would be good. We can maybe even do a coffee, have a standing meeting or something
Yeah.
like that. Just to kind of keep in touch, and as things come up, obviously would love to introduce you and put things in front of you that would make sense, hopefully.
Yeah, that's great. Do you see like some of those contact points that I had mentioned? Do you feel like those are some areas that you might have some contact points for as well?
Oh, absolutely. Definitely meeting a lot of people, and there's other investors, there's different business partners that I've worked with that might be able to benefit you as well.
That's great. But yeah, why don't we just, we could throw something on the calendar. I'll just shoot you off an email. And then we can just, just have kind of a reoccurring, thing that you and I are touching base. I'll just put it in here in the calendar, and we can get together and grab a coffee and, dive into that further. So I'm really looking forward to it. I know you got to get going, but, thanks for taking the time. And I'm excited to deepen the relationship with you and obviously just getting to know you more. It's gonna be great.
Yeah, I look forward to it too. Thanks so much for your time and some great idea.
Awesome. Well, I'll talk with you soon.
Thanks.
All right, bye-bye. Okay, so this is a what we would consider a indirect referral relationship. And the way we categorize this is we have what we consider H3 types of relationships. Those are the high integrity people, high connectors, and high givers. Those are people that you're going to be talking to on a more frequent basis. They have an attitude and a rhythm of wanting to continually give and connect you with people. They're not a dime a dozen. They are rare, but when you do find somebody along those lines, the only way you can figure that out is by going through the process that we just shared. And there are other types of referral relationships that we consider more of an ambassador relationship. They could be people that, every so often they might refer something, but you're probably not going to have a really deeper ongoing referral relationship with them. And so what we just walked through was a methodology after you've kind of, met them a couple of times and started to feel each other out a little bit. It's appropriate to establish this type of conversation with this individual or individuals to determine whether there's a reception there. If they're receptive to it, kind of like this conversation was, very receptive and open to that, that's the first step. We need to be good at legitimately asking somebody these questions and being proactive and I would say assertive to not be shy, but to ask people this. That's the first line. If it's receptive, then what you're going to do from there is to follow up and follow through with what it is that we just discussed. And then the time will tell on that follow-up call whether or not this really is going to meet itself out into something that's fruitful over time. It'll either A, manifest the way we just described it, where there really is some healthy receptivity and giving there, or B, it will not. It'll just fizzle off and it just seems like there's nothing there. But it's the starting place where we go. There could be a non-receptiveness to it. So he could have been more just like, yeah, I mean, I don't know if that's really something that I'd be able to do a lot of. That's okay. We don't mind either. We just want to know, and we can't know unless we ask. We don't have if we don't ask. That's kind of like you're not going to get deals if you're not out there making calls. It's just the way it has to be. And so you notice back and forth, what I was doing in this is I was first off starting the call with just some relational discussion. Just trying to just check in on him, see how he's doing, what's going on in your life. Okay, that's just relational building. And then I asked him if it was okay to talk for a few minutes. He said, I had a few minutes. I want to be respectful for that. I don't want to drag this on for 20 minutes or 30 minutes, but you want to do this in about a 5 to 7 minute time. You don't need a lot of time. But what I did is I started to describe to him, or it will be her, what it is that I'm trying to accomplish. You know, we're trying to set up this type of relationship where there's a reciprocal giving and back and forth to help each other grow in their respective spheres. So I'm trying to set the stage for what I'm talking about. Then what I do from there is I go ahead and start asking him first what it is he's looking for. What types of people do you want to meet? Where do you need to grow right now? You could even ask a question of what is your specific growth points or pain points right now? You just want to find out. We don't assume. There could be something completely different. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to reciprocate and share the types of people that I'm looking for. And that's really important because that's also going to help perk up his or her ears to the things that I'm looking for. And so they can already put it in their brain. So the more specific I get with my information, the more terrific I'm going to get in terms of the outcome. If I just say I'm just trying to find people, that's not going to be very helpful. But if I get real specific of real estate attorneys, commercial bankers, the more drilled down I get, the better. And I think you'll find that will go somewhere, because then all of a sudden it pops in there. Oh yeah, you know what? Actually, I know so-and-so. So those are the types of things you want to do in order to have a really effective call and one that will go a long way over time. So Dan, what do you think about that? Any feedback or thoughts or comments?
Yeah, I think it's excellent. And you know, sometimes what I look for is like, we offer to help the other person usually first. And it's always interesting to see how they kind of respond to, you know, oh, that's so exciting, thank you. But I always try to wait to see if they're going to offer it to you. Like, how can I help you in return or whatever it is? So, and you know, you did a good job of kind of navigating that, because, you know, not everyone has that. Not everyone will think about that first unless you ask. But there are some people that immediately will go, how can I help you? Or they'll even ask before you even ask how they can help you too. So I would say that's a good character kind of gauge as well on them.
Yeah, I like that. It's, you know, almost the discerning antenna, Dan, yep. Where you're really looking to say, okay, what signs am I looking for? Exactly. And that's one sign for sure. And it's a good one. If somebody immediately or even beforehand is receptive and starting to give that without even the ask, it's a pretty good sign that you're in the right direction in the right relationship. If it falls on deaf ears and there's just no receptivity to it, chances are that's going to be tricky. Not 100%, but that is a sign that you might be in the wrong relationship. The other thing is either the excitement or the non-excitement for that as well. If they get perked up about it and they're excited about it and they go, yeah, of course, that's another way as well. And then I think the final one, Dan, is that when you follow up with them, you'll really find out, is this a person that follows through with it, or are they all talk and no follow through? That's another thing you're going to have to be watchful and mindful of as well. And again, we want to be cognizant to the reality that people are busy, but if there's a pattern there, that could be definitely a sign that we need to be aware of, because you have to be extremely choosy about where you're going to allocate your priorities. So this is a call with a potential ambassador or H3 relationship where we are setting up the template that you would use in order to set up that relationship going forward in the future for Integrity Capital.